Good morning.
Morning.
Today's scripture will come from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 3, verse 22. Ye shall not fear them, for the Lord your God himself will fight for you.
Amen.
verses 9 through 14. For to this end Christ both died and rose and lived, that he might be Lord both of the dead and living people. For it is written, as I live, saith the Lord, every knee shall bow unto me, and every tongue shall confess to God. Let us not therefore judge one another anymore, but judge this brother, that no man put a stumbling block or an occasion to fall in his brother's way off. Thank you.
Okay, now.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The trial of crucifixion of Jesus is on Sunday, March 29, 2015 at 3:00 p.m. The greatest story ever told.
Yeah. Again, thank God for our visitors. Amen. Sister Law, good to see you. Amen. All the other visitors who come share with us today. Amen. Let us continually remember how sick and shedding. Amen. You may be up today, but you don't know where you're going to be tomorrow. That's why we need to handle sick folk with patience. If you was in that same position, you want somebody to have some patience with you. And how many of you can get that? Let's sing along. Give him a hand. Amen. We're going to speed up. No, I'm about to speed on up. Hallelujah. I think every child of God will have a smile on their face right now. Thank you. this song this morning. And I don't care what this is, it's one of my favorites.
Oh,
I am Jesus. My man is here.
Oh, little verses for the word. But it says, and if you can pick me up.
Lord, to be so. So.
Thou hast answered right,
This do, and thou shalt live. Look at verse 29. But he willingly to justify himself, said unto Jesus, and wills my neighbor. I want to talk about who wills my neighbor. My brothers and my sisters, we sometimes get it misconstrued and sometimes we get it twisted. That we feel as though the people who we are supposed to help are those who are close around us. We get it messed up and we realize and we think the people we only are supposed to be a blessing to are those people who run around in our clique, in our circle. Those are the people we feel as though we should be helping.
All right.
Sometimes we have that mentality, I've got mine, you get yours, syndrome. Are y'all gonna help me this morning? Sometimes we get in ourselves and we say that,
yes.
Wherever your money is in, that's where your heart is in. Somebody missed it. Wherever you spend the most time, your most money at, guess what? That's where your heart is. That's where you're going to be.
You're going to leave that alone.
Not only that, he says, but without strength, with all of our soul, and thy strength, and all of thy might. And then he said, and thy neighbor too. Then Jesus said, well, since you read the word, because you know we got a lot of people that read the word, can quote scripture on top of scripture, can tell you where to find it and everything else, but the difference is they can't. Because when I tell her what I got to tell her, she ain't gonna like me no more. How is it that you be in one post, posting about the club, posting about turning up, showing everything on your body, but then in the next breath you're gonna talk about, I need a date to take me to church and we need to come and go to church? How is it you serving to me? You talking about the devil on one day, then on Sunday morning you didn't part-time never want to talk about?
All right.
Then she wondered why she didn't get no response and who wanted to go to church with her. Because they see how you live Monday through Saturday.
All right.
Be careful. And I'm talking to me, that's going to be too out for me. Y'all agree with me?
Yeah.
Myself.
Yeah.
Watch this now. When I was a little boy, this man right here, my dad, we were staying in Georgetown West apartments. My mom over there, I never forget, had cooked two pots of beans. One bean had some sugar in it, because I love my pinto beans with sugar. Couldn't eat them without it. The other pot of pinto beans didn't have no sugar, because that's the way he likes them. My sisters was there, and I'm being big boy, trying to be big, bad, and wrong. I ate some of his beans, because I didn't want none of the other beans that was cooked for me.
But he did not hear.
unless you're trying to pin them. But what happened was, when you look down on the man, in my mind, I can hear him say, well, what did they take? Instead of helping the man, he just looked down on the man. And the Bible said that he turned and went the other direction. But oh, I thank God for this good Samaritan. When he got there, he seen the man. The man was laying down in the ditch. Come here, Mr. Come here, brother. I need you to see what I'm talking about this morning. I need you to lay down right there. Look again at the good Samaritan coming down, looking at the man. The first man was with a preacher. He looked, he went the other way. When the demon got there, the demon looked at it, said, well, what did you? But he went the other way also. But he comes up, this Samaritan, a no good sinner, looks down at the man. He wiped him, he cleaned him up, he picked him up. I don't think he picked him up, but he put him on his own horse, took him to a hotel, put him in the hotel, and told the innkeeper,
a story. Good God Almighty, I need to tell you a story. Before I go to my seat, it was said when Hurricane Katrina came through the waters. You know it tore down waters. The waters tore down a lot of buildings. Well, in Mississippi, there was three trees that had been planted by each other. Church. They got two roots in the word of
Hallelujah. I mean, when I first came to this church, that is wrong. Who you took it out of? Hallelujah. All right, are there any announcements? Thank God for all of our business who come and once again to share with us today. We pray that you come back again. Amen. Amen. Any announcements? Amen. Y'all got to pray for my bags for you. He's a good man. But he still has his temper. I thought once he got his hair cut off, he'd kind of calm down like Samson fell. God bless him. Love them all. Say, I love them all. Amen. God bless him. All right, nothing else?
Thank you.